Number 7. A small sphere hangs from a string attached to a ceiling of a uniformly accelerating train car. It is observed that the string makes an angle of 37 degrees with respect to the vertical. The magnitude of the acceleration A of the train car is most nearly? Well, we can consider that this object is under a vertical equilibrium situation, but it is accelerating forward. And if you think about the free body diagram for the forces acting here, you have that there is a gravitational force mg and a tension T acting at 37 degrees relative to a vertical line. Now, this means, of course, that the y component of the tension has to cancel the gravitational force, because there is no acceleration in the y direction. On the other hand, the x component of the tension has to be equal to mass times acceleration for this particular object. Ty can be substituted as t sine of the angle theta. T cosine of the angle theta, because the angle is with a vertical. And that's equal to mg. On the other hand, tx is t sine of angle theta, and that's equal to ma. Dividing the second equation into the first one yields t sine of theta divided t cosine of theta is equal to ma over mg. The t's cancel out, the masses cancel out, and what we have is that the acceleration is equal to g times the tangent of 37 degrees, which is approximately equal to 3/4. So this is approximately 3/4 of 10 meters per second squared, or 7.5 meters per second squared, which is option B.